Hi, everybody. Here's Krystian from TeamworkCast.
And this is Putty from TeamworkCast.
And this is Netrunner TeamworkCast. This is the 2nd of April, and this is the store championship, the final round from the store championship in Brave New World, which is a really cool little store in Cologne. And on the top table, we have Jaro, which we've been following so feverishly throughout this tournament.
Jaro is my non-culturally appropriated spirit animal.
He is, and he's playing the noise.
And he just did the thing that no one should ever do. Oh, he mixed his cards up. You poor guy. Oh, I feel bad for him right now.
Listen. Jaro is anti-meta even in the way he shuffles, all right?
No, he's looking at it, and he realized he can't get him back. He's tilted. He's tilted at the beginning of this game.
Already things are going wrong. He will be playing the noise, so he will be milling a card from top of R&D the first time he installs a virus. I know.
Oh, this mixed. Is getting... Oh my God.
I can't watch.
I can't do this.
Oh, we have to pixelate this for a while. Love it. And on the right, it's going to be Kirby. Corbinian.
Corbinian.
Oh, Kirby. I think Kirby is the nickname that you want to go for it. And so he will be playing the Palana. Palana. I don't know how to pronounce
isn't
it.
Isn't he the guy from Nirvana? Oh, that's Kurt Cobain.
Nick, I have bad news.
Oh, no, don't tell me.
Nirvana split up.
Dave Grohl, you cad.
All right. There's mandatory draw by Kirby, and he starts with a hedge fund.
Sure hedge fund.
Sure hedge fund. That's a new card.
The new ID
that he's using, he will get a credit every turn, first time the runner draws a card.
You know, I want to see a hedge fund with, there we go. Installing some ice. Hedge fund, alt art, Matthew McConaughey, Wolf of Wall Street. That's what I want to see.
Oh, that's pretty good. Mm-hmm. I like it. I approve this. So we see on Yaro's side, the Street Peddler. A very popular card. You can get host three cards up in there, and you can install one.
It is! Do it! Just do it! Oh my God, I can't siphon it.
Nick is very excited today. He's like shouting right in the microphone.
I'm sorry. I haven't talked to you in a long time, Krystian. We haven't done these games for a while. I was not enjoying Netrunner anymore. But then yesterday we did all of this, and now I'm like, yes, Netrunner!
But Netrunner is dying. Haven't you heard?
I know. I'm so glad Netrunner is dying. I hope all those people leave. Oh, I just said that out loud. Shots fired.
So it's interesting that Corbinian, that he installed an ice in front of our archives. I'm assuming that he wants be prepared for the mill because there is no viruses installed yet.
Yeah.
But Jaro takes it very slow with first installing the grimoire here.
This is the most unlike that thing that he's ever done.
And there we go. There's the first virus here.
Hey, this is the first time he's gotten grimoire out this early in the game, in the games that we've watched. All the other time it was a mid-game install.
I guess that's the way he drew.
Yep. RNG, keeping the grimoire away.
keeping with RNGesus. RNGesus, take the wheel.
You are right over there?
I've been eating peanuts, and I guess I got some residue in my... I'm not going to spare you the details, all right? All right. Anyways, here's Jackson Howard.
Ah, Jackson. It's not an alt art Jackson. I'm sad. He's the not quite creepy Jackson.
I am very happy about this. Kirby, you are my hero.
No, only use creepy Jackson. Come on.
I like how he puts the money all on the face of Leela.
Wow.
It's like some kind of like... What's this one 80s movie where Robert Redford pays Demi Moore like $1 million for a night?
Oh,
and they have sex in a bed with money.
Indecent Proposal.
Yeah, it's kind of like this kind of situation.
He's making an Indecent Proposal to Leela, huh?
Or maybe it's kind of like Game of Thrones, like burying people with coins on their eyes.
Oh, they need money for Charon? Charon? Is that his name? Oh, that's Egyptian. My bad.
Well, that's the real thing. Now, Charon, I think, is a Greek mythology, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, Greek.
I don't know, man. We are getting into, like, look how clueless we are about what? All the things that we talk about.
What? No, we know exactly what we're talking about. We're just waiting for something to happen in this incredible game of Netrunner.
Because the Jackson has been used, and now Jaro finally decides to install something with a street peddler here, and that something is going to be an imp.
Oh, I got rid of a medium for that, but I guess he can't get through anything right now anyway.
He accesses HQ. Oh man, Prism Grid! Oh, if there is a target for imp, there is one right there.
But he didn't do it!
Oh, he didn't. Oh, I'm looking for this from the perspective of a criminal, of course, as anarchy, not really, like, the Krystian Grid is not that big of a target. And there's also an data sucker.
Oh, he got rid of an ice. Again. Is that HQ2?
He wants to get rid of the ice, yeah. And interesting, there's no res on the ice in front of HQ, which is funny. I mean, it's not like Korean doesn't have the money, right?
Yeah.
He just gives him the access. Weird.
You know what it is? Huh. He splashed a Wotan.
But he could rest the Wotan, that's the thing. He has enough money to rest the Wotan.
Ah, damn it!
Okay, so he beefs up the defenses on HQ and R&D.
Wow, he's playing for the long game. It's like, whatever.
And yeah, Jaro finally wants him to rest something. Oh, Kumayo is probably out.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Jaro was looking, I guess, for something to install the parasite on. And
goodbye, all the cards.
Now that plan is out of the window. Now the question is if he wants to continue. He doesn't.
Yeah, good call. Although, that wasn't the most anarch decision you've ever made, Jaro.
That's not really rock and roll, Jaro. That's not rock and roll at all.
It's more listening to NPR in the morning on your way to work.
Yeah, that's more like easy listening.
Yanni live at the Acropolis.
Maybe Moby or something.
Moby!
Why does my heart feel so bad?
Wow.
I like Moby, actually.
Who does?
No offense. Yeah, Moby is fine. It's cool. He had some cool songs.
I'm going to tell you a secret. I'm going to tell you a secret no one else should know. I really like Yanni a lot.
Who's Yanni?
You don't want to know.
Okay. So we see a entrance being used to get back an ice trope. And then install a second ice. There's a trope and a street peddler.
You know, we've watched him for now 3 rounds. He's never actually used trope.
But he assures me that it's his favorite card.
It is an amazing card for extremely long-winded games.
Yeah, so that's the thing. Like, Trope is kind of like a card that most people never use. And I feel like I've been talking about this with Jaro, and he said, like, you should pop Trope fairly early. And we haven't seen him doing this yet, so that's kind of weird. Maybe he was just winning too fast.
It's fast.
But yeah, when I was playing my Valencia build, I was popping tropes very, very often.
Ooh.
Because you want to recur the black metals as soon as possible. And so we see the second cache.
Nice.
The early Grimoire is really doing some really good work. The caches are really valuable right now. It would be nice for him to have an S up.
Now that they have those beverages, this game's going to get interesting.
Yeah, we are crack up on some brewskis, some kölsch.
You know, I tried to get the game store here to let us drink beer while we play, but, you know, we'd all be arrested and they'd get fined.
You Americans are weird like that. I don't know. With the 21 drinking thing.
Hey.
It's weird.
It's not like we ever had a moment in time where the wives of minors got so angry and made it so no one could drink anything for a while.
You know, anything you don't have to know about the weirdness of Americans is in the movie Magic Mike XXL. I think that movie is a portrait of America's sexuality.
Or the spiritual sequel to Magic Mike XXL, Pee-wee's big holiday.
I do not agree with this estimate, but let's continue with the game here. Jaro draws a lot of cards and then plays a data sucker. Man, look at his rig being full of programs.
It's full of programs that can do absolutely nothing for him. We're seeing an RNG lock of runner proportions. It's amazing.
Well, he can safely run on stuff here, and Kirby exploits this phenomenon and just installs a card protected by an upgrade, maybe a Batty or a Caprice, and then advancing it once. If that's a Nisei Mark II, it's going to be really tough for Jaro to deal with. Jaro decides to face check wobbly into a pup.
Yep.
No problem about that. The next one is going to be Himitsubako.
What?
Himitsubako.
What's even happening here?
Why? What's the problem?
I haven't seen anyone play that card in forever.
It's a pretty good standard low-strength barrier for Jin-taking.
Ah.
Jaro is like not happy. He hasn't seen the stuff that he wants to see yet, so he face-checks this scoring server. He forces Kirby to be like, all right, I have to spend money to protect the server now. Kind of bold from Jaro. Like, if this is another Komainu...
No kidding. I mean, I guess he's trying to get him to waste all of his money, because it's the only strategy he's got left for himself.
Oh.
Lotus Field, oh.
Lotus Field is pretty tough. And then he's raising also a Caprice Nisei, just in case the Jaro has some solution for the...
Is that a Faust?
I don't quite see.
It looked...
Jaro can install something from the
Street Peddler,
but he thinks about this a lot.
There's a window of opportunity there.
The ability window.
Well,
actually, it's pain.
Actually, the priority now goes to the runner. It's step negative point three.
I can't. I just can't. And then he installs the Faust and calls it a day. I think I'm gonna.
No, it runs again.
Oh, okay. I thought
does he have the clicks? I hope he has the clicks.
And he's getting through, and they're gonna play.
Oh man, all the cards have been spent.
Uh-oh.
No cards in hand now, but they play the Psy games. They're using the Psy tokens from
he's going to be so mad when it's a cerebral image.
One versus zero. So Kirby wins this one.
Actually, I think even though he didn't get the agenda, I think that Jaro did a pretty decent job.
Well, because Kirby is down to two credits.
Yeah,
look at this.
He cannot
score this. Oh, there's some cats being very, very, very mad about
this. So, Bob, sometimes he has a chicken. We have a giant stuffed chicken. And sometimes he grabs the chicken and walks around the house screaming. And then he kind of humps it for about an hour.
That's fascinating, Nick. That's so amazing.
There you go. That's just, you know, that's what Bob's got to do. So, you know, as long as it keeps him going, that's good.
So, look at this. Jaro runs again on the server. He wants to contest the server. He really doesn't want Kirby to score this agenda. Because if he does, that's maybe Nisei Mark II, and that's going to be really, really bad. Kirby has recovered financially, so he can play the Psy game now without any problem. Oh man, Jaro trashes two. One of them is Parasite, I see. This is really tough. Ooh, the Psy game, this is so important now.
Bob update, he's staring at me and yelling. That's a.
Okay, what is
it? Oh no!
0-0! Oh man, Jaro got this! Oh, you son of a biscuit!
Oh
and that's a sales team!
Oh,
that wasn't even Nisei, that was just a sales team. But can defuse the server now. This is huge. This is a huge swing toward Jaro.
No, he discarded
a lot of cards for this, but now he's taking initiative here.
Oh man.
He forgot the trope, of course. Trope is the card that you forget so easily.
Out of nowhere, he's going to punitives.
Punitive would be great.
He's got the cash for it. Kill him. Oh, man.
Kirby can't be happy with the way this game proceeds here, but he does with celebrity gifts.
Celery. The gift of celery.
Oh, there's two Palanas Agroplexes here, the Krystian grid. There's nothing too important to score on his hand, so Jaro knows that the agendas must be in R&D now.
The real game has begun.
Wow, this is incredible. Jaro keeps drawing now. I have worse.
Has he had worse? I don't know.
He's thinking about this, but nope, he keeps drawing.
He needs to figure out how to get that account siphon. That's what he needs.
Yeah. I mean, he has a trope. He can account siphon. I guess he also forgot the trope again.
Yep. He'll forget. Oh, he just remembered.
Oh, he remembered.
He heard us.
He heard us. Yeah, was hearing us through the time vortex.
Ooh.
Oh, Jaro says, like, oh, Kirby, you make me, you exhaust me.
These are some hard-fought games he's had to deal with today.
Some battles are fought in the mind.
It's like that scene in that movie Hero where they're just, you know, staring at each other and there's a guy playing a sitar in the background.
Oh, look at this. There's a cash being installed and cash overwritten. He still doesn't have his Essos pawn shop. He really needs that money. Oh, there's the street magic going. And
street magic.
And a mimic, whatever. Oh, he gets down the wild side. That's great.
Nice.
So the wild side gives him more card draw. He hopes to draw into the pancakes and maybe later on the friggin'...
Wouldn't that be something? Oh, man. Mm-hmm. He doesn't have a whole lot of Faust fuel left.
No, but he has the tropes. He'll be fine. Okay. Oh, good. Meanwhile, Kirby gets like all the monies with a restructure here. Installs a cartnet server, but we saw that there's no agenda on his hand. And indeed, this is a Jackson Howard, which he can use to draw more cards.
Oh, man.
All right. And now with the wild side, Kirby will get a credit every time automatically at the beginning of Yaro's turn. I don't know why he runs in there, but he does.
I think he's trying to get him to just use the jacks. And...
But it wouldn't running on Arcus would be simpler?
You don't know what's in there.
Anyways, this is a Assassin.
Ooh.
It's tough one.
I didn't think Yaro's trying to get him to spend all of his money again.
Why didn't he... Did Yaro use the Jessica token? He could have used the Jessica token. Oh, he used one.
Yeah, he got it down. He's good. He's okay.
That's good.
Don't worry about it.
He good. He remember. I'm just worried. I'm just so worried about Jaro right
now. Don't
worry
about him. He's okay.
Nick, you don't understand. Jaro has never won a tournament. He's playing Netrunner for 2 years.
I haven't either.
You haven't? Nick.
I know. I run. I organize tournaments.
Every Thursday. Every Thursday he's been there and playing this game.
Oh, I kind of have given up and I've been playing other things lately. Like Formula Day.
All right, so there's an upgrade being installed in the server with a Jackson.
All this stuff going on down there. This is getting complicated.
Jaro had to, I guess, check out. He didn't access the thing.
Armitage,
yes. That's something that Jaro has been talking about a lot in recently. Oh, he got the wild cakes down. He got the pancakes down. That's great.
So, I mean, there isn't really much for Jaro to do except for him to wait until the corp gets a freaking... agenda in their hand or installed, so might as well throw
it
down.
I don't feel he has like the look, he's running out of cards. He has to find some kind of multi-access, and we know that there's a medium in his discard pile, but we also know that he discarded two Deja Vus.
Yeah,
and he's really low on money now. He really needs his Aesop. Oh, Parasite. Oh, he has to trash something. Okay, he trashes this data sucker. That's good. So he can pair the Komino if at least gets trashed. That's a huge, huge, huge change.
Oh.
Something's being rearranged. He has one. This is indeed an MU counter, what he's doing. That's great.
That, you know, I feel like I can go to bed happy tonight knowing that I've discovered a secret.
You've penetrated his mind.
Yeah, you know, it wasn't even a penetration. It was just sort of the, hey, I didn't know you were there the whole time.
And it was a more divination kind of situation. Right, so this server being protected more. I mean, it's a pretty well-protected server. The assassin itself is pretty crazy to break, I think, in most cases. And if that's a caprice or a batty behind this will be very painful for Jaro to get in here. So Jaro has a really... figure out some kind of way. Oh, he's getting confused here by the tokens, but okay. Clicks the Armitage a couple of times. And yes, there is the Aesop.
Nice. Full rig achieved. Full rig.
Oh, installing another imp.
Achievement unlocked.
Another draw here.
And he's got his Faust. All he has to hope for is that he doesn't run into a swordsman. And he'll be okay.
All right, so we're all set up now. It's all about the racing Kirby to the win. Kirby hasn't scored anything yet, so this could be a good point for Jaro to take over here.
Can't believe I thought Charon was Egyptian. What the hell's wrong with me? God.
Isn't that the moon of Pluto?
I think so.
Yeah, just charm.
Because it's a Pluto, the Lord of the Underworld.
Yeah, something like this. Oh, it's also a dog from Disney.
Oh, yeah. It's true. That was my Disney sound, apparently. It's good. It's almost as good as my Seth Rogen impersonation.
Pluto!
Oh, God.
The funny thing is, like, modern kids, another Jackson Howard going on here. Modern kids don't know Mickey Mouse anymore.
No, they don't.
Right? There's no Mickey Mouse show or anything, right?
Not no Fantasia.
Like, I grew up with Mickey Mouse, but these days it's like Minecraft. It's
There's
weird.
Not even any Looney Tunes.
Oh, man. Or Tiny Toons. Tiny Toons were the best.
Animaniacs.
Oh, man. Animaniacs or The Tick.
Well, The Tick! They're making a new live-action Tick show that's based on the actual comic books instead of the cartoon.
I am glad they do. All right, so we see finally the game starts. There's some double advance here on the, in the server. Jaro, meanwhile, pawns the cash here, gets into his money. Now, how he will contest the server now, it's difficult. He has a bunch of cards on his hand. HQ, why not? There's probably a Krystian grid there, but whatevs.
Hey, he's just hoping.
Oh, all the painful eyes for him. Two eyes will get him through here. Oh, that's actually not a Krystian grid. Oh,
my God.
Oh, that's a CyberDex virus suite. He actually had being used for 3 credits. I hope he paid the 3 credits to purge the viruses. And there's a Krystian grid. But now, of course, we don't have the money to retrash it. And Vujade.
Vujade.
What are we going to get?
Account siphon.
Oh, parasite, and I would say medium. Two parasites. What? How? What?
I mean, he.
This is insane.
He could murder the pup.
He's thinking about the cash as well. Murdering the pup would be a great thing. You can't really murder the Humi Tsubako.
Oh, because he can put it back up into his hand, can't he?
Yeah, the Himutsubaka's ability, anytime the corporation can pay in 1 credit to get it back on your hand.
Yeah, but I mean, at least so it would be gone.
Well, he can reinstall it next turn. Yeah. I mean, it could be good for like a deep medium deck 1 turn, but yeah. I wonder why he doesn't get a medium here. Maybe he has one on hand. All right, parasite on the Himutsubaka. That's not a very good choice.
Jaro, what's happening here?
Will Corbinian notice?
I mean, he could have killed the pup outright.
We'll send Pi notice there. Oh man, they're thinking about this. They're discussing this. So yeah, Corbinian takes it on his hand.
All right.
And there's an access now.
Oh my god!
Friggin' RNGesus is with Jaro today. Single access on R&D.
Oh my god.
And that is the Nisei Mark II. Corby also gets a score, but it is future perfect. Gives that to 3 points, but not really expanding his board state as the Mark II would have done in this case. So Jaro is... and he also can sell the Imp here. And so let's see what happens now. Like, you could also poke an RD one more time through the pup. There's so many things this can go now.
Wow.
This was amazing.
Wow. I mean, he believed in the heart of the cards and was rewarded for his faith.
Clearly. That's always... There we go. Now the parasite.
Now he's gone.
Oh, R&D is fully exposed now. And now he can run there with impunity. Oh, there's a Batty. Go away, Batty. We don't need your kind here.
Oh,
and there's a Jacko. Oh,
poor imps.
He doesn't have the money to trash it.
Nope. Man, this is an explosive turn that we just had.
And then he's like, "All right, let's give me the archives. I have the money to break it. I have the data sucker token." Oh, just in a pup. That's really stupid now.
He's gonna discard 2 cards.
Yeah. I mean, I would break it with at least so you can decide it.
Oh, so harsh.
Because he wanted to hit the I-Headwords. Of course, the I-Headwords is the only thing that wasn't.
Oh my
hit.
God.
That was RNGesus's
revenge.
That was RNGesus and revenge. Oh, he accessed the CyberDex here, so he will get his token purged.
Oh my god.
And there is nothing in here. He milled so many things, but none of the things are in agenda.
Oh my god.
And he's like, oh man, RNGesus has giveth, and he takes it away.
Taketh away. Oh man, I cannot believe that. That's amazing.
So installing the server. We have to assume this is the Jacksnut he just drew into.
Yeah.
It's a smart idea for Jaro to run before, because he saw that the Jacksnut was about to get drawn. So running on the archive stand was a probably good idea.
Yeah.
Trashing the imp here. What are we going to do now? Two installs in front of R&D. Yeah,
hey, don't, Kirby. Don't forget Armitage! No!
What Armitage?
He didn't take money from Armitage.
You have to click Armitage. Oh. That's not daily cast.
Oh.
Yeah. See, now he
heard me. It's good.
Yeah.
He needs that cash, man.
Yeah.
For something. I don't know what it's for.
Oh, Corona?
Oh,
it's like a real Requiem and everything. I love it. Double rainbow. Finally. Oh, now, of course, he hits the high at worst, but there's no core cards in the deck anymore.
Is he just dead? Is he just gone?
No,
Trope is there.
Oh, no rest on the second card, though. Kirby's at two credits. That's not a lot.
Yeah.
And so now Jaro, with the last click, use the trope. There we go, using him in the trope.
Finally! Man, it's been three rounds, man. Is this the last round of the tournament, or is there a championship game?
That's the last round.
All right. So you're off somewhere beating everybody?
I'm off to the side and I'm not doing too well. I lost the first round anyway, so because I wasn't there, I was learning Japanese.
Nani?
So Jaro gets back a bunch of cards with the trope.
Getting some caches, getting some Vujdays, getting some mediums. Getting some more Vujdays.
Like Jaro, please, for the love of God, get a mimic. Get a mimic, Jaro. How are we going to get in this? Oh, sweet magic, what? Get a mimic, Jaro, get a mimic.
No! Get a mimic. He doesn't get the mimic, he gets the deja vus, and then deja vus the mimic.
He can parasite it as well, that's okay.
This game, man, I tell you.
10 cards. He gets 10 cards with a trope. Wow.
And he's only got one trope in his deck?
I think so. I don't know.
That's nuts.
Maybe he gets us the second trope. That would be nice.
Yeah.
Trope the trope.
I mean, this is coming down to the wire. I don't know if he can actually pull this off.
I don't know. Jaro is at 4 points. He's fine. He just needs to find one future perfect and play a Dipsy game, and everything will be fine. All right, data sucker is not really a huge priority right now.
Yeah.
And Kirby has kind of a scoring window here, but it's so low on money.
Those Lotus Fields, those are amazing.
Lotus Fields are doing a good job here. Although two cards with a Faust.
Yeah, but he can't. Yeah.
Yeah, he cannot afford the card.
Yeah, it's another trope.
There you go, another trope.
Cash,
that's good.
Millet, bro, millet.
Mill it. You got to mill it. What? He runs there? Oh, he doesn't have any breaker anymore, any eye breaker, so he just eats the... Yes! Yes! With the ping here, Caesar and Eli, not what he wants to see here, because there will be multi-axes on R&D. And that's probably where Eli will go.
He needs to get Faust out.
There you go. Oh, man, he installed the medium to mill the Eli. Oh, yes, Jaro. Jaro fighting.
This is some high-level play right here. High level.
All right, so Kirby apparently does not too much in his turn.
No, he just kind of installed that. Is that a Krystian that he installed down there?
I don't know what he installed. I mean, it could be a Krystian, yeah.
He's been had it in his hand the whole time.
And then, bam, Parasite on the...
Mimic, or the pup.
On the pup. Check your archives, Jaro. Just check the archives, maybe.
But should he try to run through R&D once to see if he can get a couple cards? Because if he runs on archives, there's going to be a Cyberdex in there.
Data Sucker, another mill. Oh man, getting all the mills here.
How many cards does he have left? He doesn't really have many left.
Who, Corby, yeah. We don't really see. Oh, there's Jackson in there, of course. Jackson being used. And there's a purge here going on. It kind of gave up his medium token here. Bit of a bummer.
I don't know if that's the play I would have made, but I guess he doesn't want to sacrifice his... Oh, he doesn't have a... Oh, yeah. Whatever, man.
Whatever, man. I'm not second guessing him. He's doing him some magical stuff here. Street magic, you would say.
Jaro, street magic. Yeah. Street magician.
He's the... Well, what's the name of the street magician from MTV?
David Blaine.
Yeah. He's frozen himself in a block of ice on Times Square.
Oh!
See, that's a street magic right there. That's a street magic right there. See how he unstalled this ice in front of HQ? Mandatory Morning Glory.
He cannot have that many cards left. But then
it's a black square. I'm sorry, I didn't like this. The illumination values were a bit tricky to get that right here. So yeah, sure gamble on Corby's side. He wants to get up his money. He wants to start scoring here. But Jaro has been so successful at locking Corby out of this game. Oh yeah, that's not a lot. That's not a lot. There's like six cards left.
Yeah, there's really not that much in there. I didn't think so.
Yeah. Jaro can like comfortably go for a mill here.
Because he'd have to score a lot very quickly.
He remembers the clot because the clot is very important here. All right, Vujade. Nick Vujade.
Vujade?
Jade.
Jade.
Parasite and cash. He just wants to parasite and cash everything.
I like that
and
the mill.
Corby at this point says, oh man, I think you've won at this point. Which I agree, it looks pretty dope. There's a parasite being installed. He has a MU though. Yeah, he says he doesn't have any MU, but he has, so he installs a cash here for another mill. Ooh.
Oh man.
Nick. This is looking rough for Corby.
This is looking rough, but I'm liking it.
Rough. That stuff side game has maybe decided everything about how this game proceeds.
No kidding.
The one side game.
Considering you and I have seen games with up to 8 or 9...
He checks the milled cards, and that's the Psy game.
It all comes down to this.
If Jaro wins this, he wins the game. Mm-hmm. And Corby pays 2, postponing his defeat. Ooh.
I mean, do you just keep running on it until you go, or do you run?
Yeah, I guess. Oh, Corby actually. Oh man, what?
Does he run?
Install advance? What? You don't have anything to install in front of it? What? You have to install an ice there, Corby. Yeah, he does. Okay. So Corby goes for a score here.
I think that I would try to run on that crazy server, and then so he's out of money.
No way. Just go for the win on archives. Oh man, this is... Or go for the mill. There's so many ways that Jaro can win now.
Yeah. Is that one card?
Nope. Nothing left.
Is this the first mill? I think this is the first mill.
Nah, we had a lot of
mills.
Remember back in the days I was milled as CI? Those were the days. Nowadays, mill is not as unusual. But yeah, he managed a mill win here. So next turn, Corby would have lost at this mandatory draw.
And so this game is 35 minutes, so they still have plenty of time to finish their next match.
Yeah. So far, Jaro's doing good. So just to give you an idea, so he was 2 points ahead on last turn in front of Lewis. Lewis is also playing kind of like a game now, of course. So the idea is that if Jaro, if Lewis wins both games and Jaro wins only one game, then they're at the same number of points.
Yeah. Oh, we're seeing noise.
If they play the same, then Jaro wins.
Nice.
And of course, if Jaro has more points in this turn, then he wins anyway. Yeah. So winning the first game was very important for him because this sets him up.
Yeah.
If you have lost, it would have been kind of easy to for you.
So it all comes down to this next game.
It does. And we will see next turn, next video, what will happen. I will assure you
that There's maybe a couple planets are going to be hacked.
Hack the planet! Hack the planet!
Whoa.
Hack the planet!
Shut up and get in the car!
Shit on me.
Yeah, pretty much. Or maybe a dwarf planet like Pluto and Jaro.
No longer a planet.
Hmm.
It's been hacked!
This episode of Netrunner TeamworkCast was created with a generous support from our listeners. If you enjoy the show and you can't get enough Netrunner videos, please check out our Patreon campaign at patreon.com/hacktheplanet.